Amen.
Whether you are in the valley, he's there. Or you are on the mountain, he's there. The God that made the universe, he made all things. He's an almighty God. Amen. I want to share with you very briefly this morning on the fact that your own action will lead you to miracles. Your actions. You know, I like talking on action. I like talking on miracles. I like talking on us doing something. I remember in 2003, I brought a child from Nigeria that had some problem with the heart. I mentioned it before. And I was writing letters, I was pleading with people to help me raise money for the heart surgery of this 2-year-old girl. The family of this girl said they never had any firstborn daughter that survived. But thank God that girl is still alive today. Amen. That girl is now 18 years old. Amen. She survived. Amen. I remember I went to African Christian, not fellowship, Nigerian Ministers Conference meeting. And I told them, and one of the coordinators said, "Oh, that do you know about Medicaid and all those things?" God will bless one man called Dr. Abeda. Dr. Abeda came and handed the microphone. "When shall we do things for our own? Must we always depend on Medicaid and this freaking? What can you say, God? I challenge you. I do something." They never gave me any money. But to God be the glory, I told my wife one night, we are selling our house to do this surgery. I told her, my wife said, "Where are we going to live?" I said, "I don't know, but God will provide." That was that night. The following day in the morning, thank God for cell phones. My cell phone rang and I picked Dr. Bassi. "Hey, Pastor Chris, guess what? I bumped into a colleague of mine who's a child cardiologist. When I told him the case, he said, oh, he's going to do it for 501c3. So when can you bring the girl, so that Dr. Thompson can see?" I said, "I can bring her now." And I took her there that same day. Dr. Thompson said, "Well, I'm going to do it. But the hospital bill would be $7,000. I didn't have that. But he said, "No, you know what? You're a pastor." I said, "Yes, okay. Hold on." He made some calls and then he came back and said, "You will pay 50%. So I ended up paying not up to $4,000. And the heart surgery was done. And the girl survived. And she's still alive today. Why am I sharing this testimony? We can act. And what Pastor Abuja eventually preached at the testimony of that girl before she left for Nigeria, he said, "You don't know what is called miracle. This is a miracle. That the surgery was done is a miracle. To him is a miracle, and to me is a miracle. You are going to live here with a miracle. Your case may be a very difficult one, and you may have complained. But there's a woman in the scriptures that obeyed God in her difficult situation. She acted according to the word of the man of God. When Pastor Benjamin gave a testimony, I almost stopped preaching because he preached my message. He said, the pastor said on Wednesday, you remember what he said? The pastor said on Wednesday, if you believe the prophet, you shall prosper. 2 Chronicles 20:20. Verse 20b. They believe their prophets, so shall you prosper. How do you believe your prophet to prosper? By acting on what he said. By doing what? Acting on what your prophet, your pastor, your minister say. And I'm telling you, First Samuel
We know about Elkanah and Anna. Anna had no child. Penina, the co-wife to Elkanah, had children. And she troubled Anna. And they went to Shiloh to go and pray. And Anna prayed with her heart. Her tongue was vibrating. She never uttered any word. Whatever happened is immaterial. But the man of God came and said, go home, and may the Lord grant you the desire of your heart. Today I want to challenge you to act on what you have been hearing. What has been preached to you many, many, many times here. Act on that. And my Bible tells me that that woman's countenance changed for good. And she went home. She didn't say, how am I supposed to know? Am I sure? Pastor didn't. No, she believed. Yes. She believed. Blessed is she that believeth, for there shall be a performance of that which was spoken unto her of the Lord in the book of Luke 1:45. Do you believe? It does not matter how your situation is. Listen. You may be a daughter of Zelophehad. If you believe that God will change your situation, He will. I don't care who told you that your job, you cannot get promoted. I don't care whoever said to you that your business will not prosper. It doesn't matter who said what they say. What does your minister say? What does your pastor say?
Yes.
What is it that he said? My Bible told me that Anna went home and the Lord remembered her.
Amen.
Because she believed and went home in that belief. Do you believe? Do you know what Jesus told Martha? At the tomb of Lazarus. Oh, she told Jesus, if he had come, my brother would not have died. And Jesus said, your brother shall live again. And she said, yes, I know, at the resurrection. And Jesus Christ said, well, since you are going that route, what am I going to do now to bring this woman here? Okay, I am standing here. I am the resurrection. I am the life.
Hallelujah.
Do you believe this? She said, yes, I believe that you are the one to come. She was always changing. Then he got to a time, Jesus said, take away the stone. What did she say? By now, he's still dead. Because he had been dead 4 days. And what did Jesus say? Didn't I tell you, I think it's verse 39 or 40 of John 11. Didn't I tell you that if you believe, you shall see the glory of the Lord? My Bible says at that point, they took away this stone. They took it. May you get to a point that you believe enough to take away this stone.
Yes.
Any stone that may make you to think that yours is to stay and not be blessed. God forbid.
Amen.
God forbid.
Amen.
I said, God forbid.
Yes.
Anytime I stand here to share testimony about my job, you know, I always make a comment that they always tell me, oh, we don't need you anymore. And then later on, they will call me, it is either you or no one. It has happened to me three good times. One thing I want to leave you with is, why not just believe and act?
Amen.
Believe without action is nothing. If you believe, you act. And if you're a woman and you want to say, God, my day has come, tell your husband, if you don't have any child, challenge God. Tell your husband when you get home. Our next paycheck, we're going to buy baby bassinet.
Amen.
Why not do that?
Amen.
A minister went to South Africa to go and minister, a missionary. And he went there, and he had been praying for God to give him food. He prayed that God should give him food. There was no food. And this morning, he said, God, I just want to drink milk. I want to drink milk.
And God said to him, I'm going to give you milk and more. And that morning, as it was spring, this truck that normally goes to distribute milk missed his way. And when he looked at the time, he decided to go to that street. And he was giving people milk. And he came to his door and gave him, supplied him with milk that was going to last him for long. He asked the man, but I've never seen you before. He said, I missed my way. God will cause blessing to miss his way.
Yes.
And come to your side.
Yes.
That is what will happen. Yes. I plan, look at this thing, there are many pages. I plan to preach on many pages. But the Lord said, challenge my people. What we were saying, he said, challenge them to believe what they have been hearing. It's not every time you keep hearing and hearing and go home, when you leave this door and everything is gone. No, when you just believe, can you just believe the few words you have? What is it that you want? Challenge God in it.
Yes, sir.
You want to go to college, you've not gotten an admission. Get the broker of that school. Begin to buy the books you will use in the next class. And I can assure you, if you believe God, Jesus said, didn't I tell you that if you believe, you shall see the glory of God? What is the issue? Why are we not believing? In 1 Kings chapter 17, there's a man called Elijah the Tishbite. The very first time Elijah's name is mentioned is in 1 Kings chapter 17. And Elijah the Tishbite, he came and appeared before Ahab and said, as the Lord of hosts liveth, before whom I stand, there shall be no rain. This day, this year, according to my word, he acted. He acted. Listen, when you act, God acts.
Yes.
It doesn't matter the difficult situation, God will act on your behalf.
Amen.
And when he spoke, heaven put a signet of authority on it. And there was no rain. But remember, it was a pronouncement of judgment that affected him also. There was no fruit. There was no water. But God will always create a brook to take care of his own.
Amen.
When he walks with him. And the Bible says God took him to the brook Cherith. You can read that in 1 Kings 17. He went to the brook Cherith. And he was drinking from the brook. And God said, no, no, no. You are not only going to drink, I'm going to feed you. You know what God did? He fed him with what? From where? Who was the servant? Who was the maid? He's a reverend. Study the life of a reverend. It is the mightiest bird in the world. If a reverend goes to catch a prey to eat, and while the reverend is up there eating, and a tiny piece drops, he will leave that one there. Nobody ties it. He will leave that one day and pursue the tiny piece that dropped. Too bad for a rat, for a rabbit, for anything to eat it, he would tear it into pieces to get that small piece. He doesn't share. He does not believe in sharing. That's a lot. But that's what God used. Something that doesn't share, God used it to feed a man of God. Who acted? Who believed God, who trusted God, God used that. Let me tell you, even your enemies, even your enemies will become your servants.
Amen.
Amen.
I told someone that the waters that destroyed others will save
you. Amen.
Do you know that Moses was brought up in Pharaoh's house? The same Pharaoh that killed people of Moses' age at 2 years and below. Is it when God orchestrates things, he makes it to happen in your favor?
Amen.
So God began to walk
that disturb you in their work, they will turn around to favor you. Because I saw it in my Bible, in Psalms 23, the Lord says in that word, he said, he prepares a table before me, where? In the presence of my enemies. The whole earth is the Lord's.
Amen.
And so if you decide to prepare a table before your God, before that man or that woman who is troubling you, he's going to do it.
Amen.
All you need to do is what? Believe. Maybe the title of this message is All You Need to Do Is Believe. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So God will do it. He will do it for you. He will accomplish his purpose because of you.
Yeah.
All you need to do is, can I challenge you to always come to church with a notebook? And whenever the pastor preaches or whoever stands there to preach, you jot it down. When you go back home, you look at it and believe what you have looked at.
Yes.
It will benefit you.
Yes.
The world will benefit
you.
Because there will be a performance of those things that were spoken of you by the Lord. Then the brook dried up after a while. And the Lord spoke to Elijah. And he said, and this will baffle you. He said, go to Zarephath, for I have commanded. If you look at your Bible, verse 9 of 1 Kings 7, he said, arise, get into Zarephath, which belonged to Zidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded a widow woman there to sustain me. He said, he commanded. God commanded. But do you know when Elijah went to the gate and saw this woman gathering of two sticks and told her, give me some water to drink? She went. She was going to bring water. And he said, also a piece of cake. You know what she said? I have nothing. As the Lord your God liveth. If God had commanded her, why would she speak like that? What does that mean? It means that when God puts people on your path to honor and glory, they may not even know. And when they respond to God's orchestration, everything begins to happen.
Amen.
All you need to do is to believe that it is God that has spoken to you.
Amen.
I have learned now that I don't care who has made promises to me. It doesn't matter. You don't have to make a promise before blessings will begin to come. Because if God could command a woman who didn't know that God was commanding her, then God will do it for you too.
Amen.
Did you get that?
Yeah.
Now, do you know that this woman lived in a Zeph that belonged to Sidon? Zarephath was a completely idolatrous city. It is in the modern day Lebanon. It was completely idolatrous. Nothing good could come out of there. No man, no woman knew God. But look at God decided of his own. I don't know how he did it, to select this woman and put his spirit in. Jezebel, the wife of Ahab, is from Zarephath. And when she came to marry Ahab, she brought the evil of Ahab and influenced Ahab and Israelites. But look at it. There was a woman in that same place that God planted to take care of a man of God.
placed the table before me in the presence of my enemies. Remember I told you about Moses, who was brought up in Pharaoh's palace. When Jesus Christ was to be king, he ran to Egypt that feared not God. Let me tell you something. The heir is the Lord's.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what is happening to you, as long as you begin to tread on the land you possess it.
Amen.
The land becomes your own by possession. Because there is a God we serve. That's why I love that song. I couldn't but allow us to keep singing it. You are a mighty God.
Yes.
My God is a mighty God.
Yes.
I am serving a mighty God.
Yes, He is.
When doctors told us that we should adopt, my wife began to cry. I told her, don't cry. I wanted to comfort her, but I made a blunder. Excuse me. I made a big blunder. And I innocently did it. I told her, am I not more than 10 sons to you? Oh my goodness. The speed with which the hand came to slap me was serious, and I dodged. What did I do? He said, you don't know what you're saying. I'm a married woman. I'm supposed to be a mother. And she cried and cried. And we prayed. Simply forgot. Following month, we woke up in the morning. I told her, you are pregnant. She said, I'm not. I said, yes, you are. I'm not. Yes, you are. I'm not. Yes, you are. I said, until you agree you are pregnant, I'm not going to work. She said, what's your problem? I said, I have no problem. He said, how do you know I'm pregnant? I said, I don't know. He said, if you don't know, then why do you say I'm pregnant? I said, because you are. She just kept quiet. She didn't agree, but she didn't argue. And I was happy. She took a bag and drove her at work. She couldn't do anything at work. She was thinking, and then one elderly Igbo lady asked her, Miss Julie, are you okay? She said, yes, but my husband said something to me this morning. I don't understand. And then told her, she said, what's your problem? You told me your husband is a pastor. Well, I don't believe it. Go across the street and see CVS. Go and buy a test kit to convince yourself. If a man will come tell me that kind of a thing, if I'm in their shoes, I will believe. She went in, read, bought a test kit, came to the bathroom and did it. It was positive. And that's the girl you see who is my hand back here, everybody. Knocking on my door. And after that, we lost two through miscarriages. And I told her, I know what. You are now a mother. I don't want to lose you. I don't know how I will survive taking care of this girl alone. So let's forget about children and take care of this one. You are now a mother. Whenever mothers are called, you will appear. Please, if you believe God, many things will happen in your life.
Amen.
Can I challenge us to believe God to build our church?
Yes.
It's in your hand. You know that my song? It's in your hands. You hold your miracles. They're not much to you. Turn it to Him and He'll take what you give to Him and make it what it ought to be. Your miracle is in your hands. It's in your hands. Your miracle is in your hand. How you believe God matters. And so this woman told Elijah, as the Lord your God liveth, there's nothing. Elijah said, but there is something. Look at verse 12. And she said, as the Lord thy God liveth, 1 Kings chapter 17, 12. I have not a cake, but a handful of meal in a barrel and a little oil. I love her qualifications of what she had. A handful of meal, little oil in a cruse. And behold, I'm gathering two sticks So, handful, little, and two. Nothing to amount anything. And God always takes from nothing to build great things.
Yes.
I hope you know that every great thing started little.
Yes.
God wanted to populate the world. He started with one man, one entity, called Adam. When he made Adam, like Pastor preached that time, if you look at Genesis chapter 5, verse 2, in King James Version, he said, God blessed them and called their name Adam. That's King James Version of Genesis 5, 2. He blessed them and called their name Adam inside one body. He called their name Adam. Then after that, God now separated this Adam. I wrote something on that, and I say that I talked to women. I say, women, just have mercy on us, because you guys are version 2, we're version 1. You know, version 1 contains a lot of words. For those of you who are in the computer field. Version, the reason why there is a version 2 is because of the words of version 1. So when you now come with version 2, there is a lot of improvements. That's why you get computer updates. That's why you have updates, upgrades. So come from the lower version to a better version after a lot of bugs have been fixed. Unfortunately, we are version 1. So that's why you don't fight us too much. That's why sometimes we misbehave. Sisters, those of you who are our wives, have mercy on us.
Amen.
We are still version 1.
Amen.
And God will help us. Praise God. So when we mess up, know that on this one, we are leftovers actually. You know, leftovers sometimes think. Leftovers sometimes nobody desire. Out of this one, the Lord took a bone to make you. And then the leftover, we are seeing called men. You get the point?
Yes.
You get my point?
Yes.
So please, have mercy on us. When we mess up, just say, I don't blame you, you are version 1. Pray for us.
Amen.
To fit into you and to meet your need in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So this woman said, I don't have anything. I have a handful, I have a little, and I'm just going to get 2 sticks. And the man of God said, you are the one that is qualified for the miracle from God.
Amen.
He said, go and do what I've said. And then he said, wait now, for thus says the Lord, verse 14, for thus says the Lord God of Israel, what did God say? The barren of me shall not waste, neither shall the cruse of oil fail, until I undermine the word, until the day that the Lord sendeth rain upon the earth. Listen, that's why I say it will blow your mind. He said, you are qualified for a miracle until the time comes when you don't need the miracle anymore. In other words, right now you need a miracle.
Yes.
But when the rain comes, you don't need the miracle anymore. Because when the rain comes, you can now go back to your work and do what you were doing. This woman was very industrious. That's why she could gather food for her household. That's why she could have the meal. That's why she could have the oil. But because of lack of rain for many years, her reserve started running down until this time. And God, in his infinite eyes and powerful eyes, said, that's where I'm going to use to feed you.
Amen.
And set a light on there. Why? Because there is always a blessing that follows a man of God.
Amen.
The entrance of that man of God into that house brought miracles.
Amen.
He spoke. Now listen. When God wants to bless you, most of the time, He doesn't just talk to you to bless you. He talks to your pastor. And then when you meet your pastor, He began to unfold what God has spoken to you, but it's hidden. That's exactly what happened here. How do I know? Because of previous verse saying God commanded a woman to feed him. But the woman had no knowledge that she had been commanded by God. Until the man of God got into her life, her eyes were opened by the word He spoke, by the commandments of God through the man of God. She acted on it. When the man of God told her, nothing will happen to you, just give me first. I hope you know she didn't argue. She didn't say, what kind of man of God is this? Always asking for money. The house of God needs to be built. God told them in the days of old, you are living in their sealed houses. You are inventing instruments like David. You are enjoying yourself and eating fat food.
The air condition.
And yet the house of God lying waste. Listen, there's a miracle coming your way.
Amen.
All you need to do is to believe. Believe the word of God.
Amen.
Act on what has been said.
Amen.
Go beyond. I have seen God. I have seen God. I wanted to borrow money to revive my business. And my wife said, I thought you're a faith man. You're a preacher. Then God said you should borrow. And I became quiet. I said, God didn't tell me to borrow. She said, okay, I'll leave it to you. But I'm not with you. And I went and prayed the Lord, said, listen to me. Don't abort my miracle in your life.
Amen.
Don't bring an Ishmael into this family. Because an Isaac is on his way.
Amen.
Please, don't always be in a hurry and act in the flesh. Always go before God and ask, do I do this? And if God says do, then you do it. If God doesn't tell you, don't do it. No matter how pleasant and how enticing. And this woman, listen to the man of God. And I believe that when God said, I have commanded, God put an interest in her. That was why she recognized him as a man of God in a land that had no men of God. And she said, as the Lord your God needed. So she recognized. And when the man of God said, just go and do it. Do you know that the meal of flour did not diminish? The cruse of oil did not fail until 2.5 years. Where was Elijah all this while? In her house. God used her to take care of the man of God. No complaint and nothing. Do you know that God wants to lift you up? Do you believe? By the way, do you believe this word? Do you believe the simple word of God? If you believe this, there will be a blessing. There will be a performance. Listen, there is nothing that is impossible for God to do. He says, I am the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me to do? What is it that you are looking for? It's in your hand. It's according to your belief. You hold your miracle. You hold your miracle by the comprehensive faith in the name of Jesus. You can move mountains. You can raise the dead. You can be the man that God wants you to be. God can use you to change the destiny of many people. God will use you to change the destiny of many. Can you just pray simply and say, Lord, help down the level of my belief. I want to believe. I want to believe. I want to believe the word. I want to believe the word.
21. Blessed is she that believeth, for there shall be a performance. God, bring me to a point that I'll believe, for there to be a performance of what you have spoken. God will perform. God will perform. I say God will perform.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I speak to your situation. I speak to your situation. What has been difficult for you will no more be.
Amen.
I destroy the root of difficulties in your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I destroy the root of difficulties.
Amen.
I also destroy the root cause of difficulties.
Amen.
When you step out, the Lord shall add his amen upon your action.
Amen.
Your actions will lead you to miracles.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
When you believe, you will see that performance. That there is sickness in your body. And you've had these few words. All I'm saying is, if only you believe, you will see the glory. You will see the glory of God. In the name of Jesus, may you believe that that glory may descend upon you. In the name of Jesus. You will not cast your lot. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every root cause of sickness, I destroy it.
Amen.
If you are struggling to take care of even the elders back home, that struggle has ended.
Amen.
The Lord will lift you up.
Amen.
You shall be the head and not the tail. You shall be a and I ask of you,
amen.
Oh Lord, to bless your people.
Amen.
Bring transformation.
Amen.
Bring transformation.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, that which have allowed me to speak, confirm.
Amen.
I pray.
Amen.
I pray for confirmation of these words.
Amen.
That if any man, if any woman, if any child believe you, God will answer.
Amen.
And bring forth a miracle. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Father, we pray for our pastor that you will cause us to believe the word of his mouth.
Amen.
So that we will prosper.
Amen.
I pray for the pastor's wife that you will cause us to believe that which he tells us to do.
Amen.
We want to be a people of blessing.
Amen.
A people of breakthroughs. A people that experience the blessings of God.
Amen.
Father, Pastor Suji is the head man in this house.
Yes, Lord.
We receive grace to believe.
Amen.
That which he has said. Because we want to prosper under him.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, for answering us. Any man, any woman, any brother, sister that stands on this pulpit and declares the thing for us to believe, Lord, we believe.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.